It is in Sahih Bukhari from Huzaifa radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He says, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that a talebearer will not enter Jannah, means paradise. Bayhaqi reported in Shu'bul Iman from Abdur Rahman bin Ghanam and Asma bint Yazid radiallahu ta'ala anhuma that Nabi Kareem sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, the pious servants of Allah are those by looking at whom one remembers Allah, and the wayward servants of Allah are those who are involved in talebearing, means backbiting, and those who cause separation between friends, and those who intend to cause hardship upon one who has already been acquitted from any false accusations, means wrong action. It is in Sahih Muslim from Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu that Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, do you know what is meant by gheebat? The people said, Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam know best. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, backbiting is to say something about your brother which he dislikes. Someone asked, even if what I say is true about my brother? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, if such defects which you say are true about him, then you have committed the ghibat against him. And if he does not have what you say, then you have committed buhtan against him. Bayhaqi reported from Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma that two persons performed their zuhr or asr namaz, and both of them were fasting. When they had both completed their namaz, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, both of you should perform wudu and repeat your namaz and complete your fast, and then make repeat that fast on the following day. They said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is the reason for this command? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you committed ghibah, means backbiting, regarding a certain person. Tirmizi reported from Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I dislike it when someone is being imitated even though I may get so much for it. In other words, to imitate or mimic is not correct opposed to anything in the world. Bayhaqi reported in Shu'bul Iman from Abu Sa'id and Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhuma that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ghibat, means backbiting, is more harmful than committing adultery. People asked, what is the reason for backbiting to be regarded as more harmful than adultery? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man commits adultery, then repents, and Allah Almighty accepts his repentance, whereas the repentance of one who commits ghibat will not be pardoned unless the person whom he has backbitten does not forgive him. It is narrated from Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu that a person who commits adultery is able to repent, but there is no repentance for one who backbites. Bayhaqi reported in Da'wat-e-Kabir on the authority of Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu that Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, the kafara of backbiting is that one should make istighfar for the one whom you have made ghibat against by saying, Allahumma ghfir lana walahu, means, O Allah, pardon me and him.